Hello students, today we will be going through the Kirchhoff's current law experiment. So we will be verifying the KCL experiment here. So this is the circuit, you can see this circuit. So you have three resistors, 330 ohm resistor, 220 ohm resistor and 1 kilo ohm resistor. So we will rig up this circuit first. So first see the board here. So you can see this board. So we have included the resistors behind here. So for your exams you might have different resistors other than that 330 ohm, 220 ohm and 1 kilo ohm. So you just have to check first which resistors are connected behind the board and then do the calculations accordingly. So first let us see this manual. So you can see here from the regulated power supply the one connection is gone to 330 ohm resistor, which is nothing but the R1 resistor. So from here you can see from the positive I have taken it to the R1 resistor. Next if you see the manual, see here from the next point it has gone to the A1. A1, A2 and A3 are nothing but the ammeters, that is the current measuring instrument. Now for current measuring here we will be using the multimeters. So in this board you can see there are three knobs given, one for A1, next second one is given for A3, next is given for A2. So I will be using this. So according to this manual what happens is from 330 ohm the connection goes to A1. So I have taken from 330 ohm the connection is taken to A1. So you can see here. Next, from the A1 the connection is gone to A2 and another connection is gone to A3. So what I have done is one connection I have taken to A3, then from A3 I have taken it to A2. So from A3 I have taken it to A2 connection. Next, from A2 connection you can see it goes to 220 ohm. So A2 is here, from A2 it goes to 220 ohm, that is nothing but the R2 resistor. Next, from the other end of the R2 resistor it goes to the 1 kilo ohm resistor, which is nothing but R3. So from here it goes to R3. Next, the other end of the 1 kilo ohm is gone to A3. So other end of the R3 is gone to A3. So next, this connection was already done, that is nothing but A3 to A2. So you can see here A3 to A2 is done. Next, this one connection is left. So this is nothing but, you can see from the negative power supply we have taken it to R3 connection, that is nothing but 1 kilo ohm. So you can see from the regulated power supply negative is gone to R3. Now we will start with the experiment. So what we will be doing is we will do two different cases here. One where I will be setting the regulated power supply for 10 volts and another one where I will be setting the regulated power supply for 15 volts. So let me start. First let me set it for 10 volts. So it has already been set here now. Now you can see here A1, A2, A3, three multimeters have to be connected in order to find out the current. Now you already know the current can always be found out only in series. So what I am doing is I will connect this in series. Now according to your circuit we have to use three multimeters, but in order to reduce those three multimeters to one multimeter, what I will do is I will use one multimeter here for A1, another two connections for, that is for A2 and A3, I will just short it. So next when I am going to measure the A2 current I can just short the other two connections, that is A1 and A3. When I am going to measure A3 I can short A1 and A2 connections. So I have already done the connection, now let me measure first the current A1. So A1 if you see it is nothing but 9.6. So you can see here the multimeter is kept for milli and the it is kept in the current mode DC and it is kept for milli, that is nothing but the current that shown here is 19.62 milliamps. So your first current, so you can take down first the voltage that was given was 10 volts. So current I1, I2 and I3 has to be found out. So first we found out I1 current, that is nothing but 9.62 milliamps. Next, let me find out the second current. So what I'll do is I will remove this multimeter. I'll short the A1 connection. So keep the multimeter in the A2 connection. So the current that I'm going to, that I find is 16.04 milliamps. So I2 is 16.04 milliamps. Next, take this connection from A2, short it. And keep the multimeter in the A3 connection. So you can see you are going to find the current as 3.56 milliamps. Similarly, you can do for the next case where I am going to keep the voltage for 15 volts. So you can see here I will keep it for 15 volts. So I have kept it for 15 volts now. I'll measure the current now, I1, I2, I3. So what I'll do is I'll keep the multimeter in the A1 connection and short the other two connections, that is A2 and A3 connections have been shorted. So you can see it is in the larger range. Therefore, what happens is if you keep the multimeter in 20 milli range, you'll not get the answer. That is why, because the answer is slightly bigger. So what I'll do is I'll keep it in 200 milli range. Now, so you can see the current obtained is 28.9 milliamps. So 28.9 milliamps. Next, I'll remove the connection in A1, short it, and I'll keep the connection for A2. So you can see here the current found out is 24.3 milliamps. Next, remove the connection in A2, short A2, and keep the multimeter for A3 connection. So the current found out is 5.3 milliamps. So this is how you do your KCL experiment. Similarly, you can do for other voltages. Thank you.